So it was quite far into the post-war period. There was a lot of Japanese pent-up desire for the reconciliation process. One of the pieces of the puzzle in the 1970s was this territorial dispute, and that was over these small isolated islands called the Senkaku by the Japanese and Jiayu by the Chinese. And they were in the middle of the East China Sea, they were remote. They were inhabited by Japanese, impoverished Japanese, I should say, in the 1920s into the 1930s when they basically left the island. But it was a very small, remote place and very difficult to get to. Fishermen go through those waters, Chinese fishermen today, Taiwanese fishermen traditionally, as well as fishermen from the Okinawan Islands of southern Japan. So these islands, both countries claimed, well, all three, I should say, Taiwan, China, and Japan claim sovereignty over these islands. For the Chinese, the position is that those islands were taken by the Japanese through war and conquest, and they should have been returned during the peace treaty. It came up in the negotiations and it proceeded in the negotiations. In the final stages in 1978, when the two countries were concluding this much anticipated agreement, the Chinese sent hundreds of fishing boats out there in a kind of demonstration of their continued interest. But basically, Deng Xiaoping, when he came to Japan to ratify the treaty at the final stages, said, let's put this aside for future generations. We'll leave it to the wisdom of future generations to solve this sovereignty issue. The Japanese made no public statement at the time, but basically both governments backed away and said the interests of the larger relationship should take precedence.
So let me then ask Richard McGregor to take this forward for us, because future generations are now grappling with it and it's getting more difficult.
That's right. Deng said put it aside, but the Chinese claim that since then, you know, Japanese nationalists have not put it aside and put sovereignty back. Most recently, in 2012, when a stepped in to stop it, the Chinese government said, okay, well, we've reopened the issue. So that's when they started
the basic history going back, just to sort of summarize.